Hey folks, welcome to the channel. Today we're going to start a new build, a triple build. This means that we're going to start three knives at the same time and go through progression on each knife together. So this should be interesting. The first knife is going to be a Kumai, which is a copper kind of Damascus knife. It'll have an 80 CRV core, copper, 15 and 20, copper, 1080.
All three knives are going to be done using my Thresher pattern. The second is going to be 80 CRV2, just mono steel. And the third is going to be a stainless San Mai with 416 cladding and a 1080 core. Let's get into it. Like all forge welding projects, we're going to start this out by cleaning it up on the surface grinder. The great part about this one, I didn't have to remove the sticker, I just ground it off. If you have a 2x72 and you don't have one of these surface grinders, you really should consider making one. I'll put a link up to the video where I review mine and have a parts list. Here I'm welding up the seams on both the Kumai and the San Mai and getting them in the forge. Once I get these up to forge welding temp, I'll just give them a little squish to set the welds. The one thing I had to be careful of is that the stainless San Mai, I actually needed it at forge welding temperatures, but the Kumai, I did not want it at forge welding temperatures because that would have melted out the copper. This worked out though, because the Kumai billet's a little thicker and I actually put it at the side of the forge so it wouldn't heat up quite so much. The great part about doing multiple knives at the same time, I got both of them in the forge, I do one, put it back in the forge, do the other, and I can just go back and forth. This worked out really well. This is a really important step, using these aggressive round dies. This gives you that wavy pattern down your blade and you don't just get a straight line. So it's really important to use these on San Mais. I've learned over trial and error that definitely the way to do San Mai is to weld up all of the seams. Don't let any air inside it and you're good, especially on the stainless San Mai. While I let the San Mais cool, I'm working on the 80 CRV blade, which is really just stock removal, so I'm cutting it out on the bandsaw. Now I'm just grinding in the profile on the 2x72. You probably noticed this one is a hidden tang instead of a full tang. I decided since it's only mono steel, I would go a little extra and do a guard on this one. Now it's time to do the profile on the Kumai. When I was forging this one, I actually let it get a little too hot on one end and some of the copper squished out. But when I was doing the profile, I thought it looked fine, but you'll see later that I do have a problem. Being able to use the small wheel attachment in a horizontal mode is a real game changer. I didn't realize how much I missed this by not having it, but now that I have it, I love it. All the profiles are done, ready to remove some scale and put in some bevels. I figured I would use the surface grinder just to get these all nice and flat and even before I started putting my bevels in, which was a good idea. You can see on the end of the tang here where some of the copper leaked out, which didn't still seem like a problem, but again, watch a bit later and you'll see why it became a problem. Like always, putting on some layout fluid, scribing some lines so I can grind to those lines for my initial bevel preheat treat. I can't stress enough how important it is to draw this center line down your blade edge. Otherwise, you have no idea how far, how centered your blade, your bevels are on the blade. So this part is really, really key. Just like on the edge, I also put a center line on the top because the false edge is going to go there, and I need to do the same process for the false edge. If you're trying to learn how to grind freehand, pay close attention to where my fingers are against the blade and where my arms are against my sides. You want to keep your arms in, you're really moving your body, not your arms. And the first thing I'm doing is just kind of breaking those 90s and putting almost a 45 degree angle, and then I'll work that down the blade. You're going to just keep working that bevel until you get it a little wider and wider, enough that when you press your thumb against the knife, against the platen, it kind of sits there on its own. I'm only showing the grinding on the first knife because it just gets monotonous after a while for you guys to watch, but it was really cool to be doing three of these at the same time. I felt like my grinds just got better and better with all three, and I think in total it took me maybe an hour to do all three. Here you get your first glimpse of the kumai pattern, and I'm really excited about how this is looking. I love the fact that it's jumping up and down. It almost looks like a heartbeat down the blade. Here I'm drilling my pinholes for the kumai and for the stainless san mai. I didn't really anneal these first, and I kind of pay for it. I couldn't drill through the second hole through the kumai, so I ended up having to go back and anneal these later. Here I'm trying to drill a stainless san mai and it's not going at all. After annealing all three in the oven at 1600 degrees and letting them cool overnight, I was able to drill through all of the handles. You can see here I've put all of the weight reduction holes in the handles as well. And now it's time to put in the false edge with my file jig. I feel like I'm finally mastering this process of putting in the false edge. And these are tricky because these are not a straight edge, kind of like a harpoon edge. These are curved, which makes it a little more challenging.
False edge is completed on all of these. Holes drilled for the handles. This one's rough ground. I'll do the hole after. Time for normalization.
I've done three normalization cycles. Now I'm doing the quench. This first knife is the stainless san mai. That one goes into Parks 50 because it's got a 1080 core. I realized when I was doing this that I've never really recorded a video on heat treating. So watch this week's Triple T for a full explanation on the whole heat treat process and why it's important to use the proper quench oil for the different steels that you're using. Here goes the Kumai into the quench. This one's going into Park's AAA. Don't you just love how that copper pops as soon as you pull it out of the quench? I love it. And finally, the 80CRV mono steel blade, it gets its quench.
So here are the blades after heat treat and temper. They've come out pretty nice. Here's the Kumai. I love the multicolor on the copper. Too bad it doesn't stay that way, but it looks pretty cool right now. It's got kind of almost like a rainbowy pattern. I love that the pattern goes up and down and that it kind of joins when it hits the false edge. So this is gonna look really cool when it's done. The stainless San Mai looks good. This will obviously come up higher once the final grind is done. It's nice and straight. And then the mono steel one also looks really good. So the Kumai is what gave me a problem. So when this came out of the first normalization cycle, there was a crack here in the tang. You can see it here. I've ground it down a bit just to see if I could go through that. And you can see there's another crack here. I'm pretty sure that's where the copper ended up melting out. So there's nothing holding those two, the two metals together there. Luckily, it does not go any further than here. So what I'm going to do is actually do, it's kind of a different, I'm going to cut the top of this like this, and I'm going to do kind of a wraparound handle. You'll see what I do in the next episode. The only other issue that the Kumai gave me is there's ever so slight of a warp just at the tip, the front inch of the tip, but I'll take that out in grinding. But I love how this Kumai has turned out, so I want to make sure I can salvage it. So you'll see what I do to the tang. Thanks for joining me, folks, on the first part of this build. It was really interesting doing three knives at the same time, and there's definitely a lot of optimizations in doing things at the same time instead of finishing a full knife. So I can see myself doing this in the future. So I'm pretty excited about going further on these knives, and I'm really happy the way they're turning out. A little glitch on the Kumai, like I mentioned, but I'll get it fixed. So join me on the next one. We'll be finishing the grinding on these, putting the handles on them. And guys, please, it takes a lot to do these videos, so I appreciate it. Go down, hit that like button, subscribe, and join us on the next one. Thanks, folks.